Oh, god damn it, Gaijin. It's break, and you still don't allow us to choose where to spawn? Come on, what's the point of that? Seriously, man? Okay. Simulator! Yay! Time to get shot by fucking idiot teammates! Yay! Very pretty, though. Oh, boy. I'm not used to this spawn. Hell yeah, I'll take it. I'll take it, man. That's what I do. Bang and bang, doba dee doo. Got any more AC4 Thunderbolts? Good. So hopefully I won't be the only one to be killed by a teammate. There's a firefly up there. It's finally my chance to... oh shit, I should have put on a booster. Shit. Whatever, it's finally my chance to grind out some of the Brits. Without needing to fight Tiger H1s. Which I can easily fight. 17 pounder has no problem sawing right through it, but the teams, it's always a loss. Almost every single match I play against the Tiger H1 in simulator battles results in a complete failure defeat. Which I wouldn't really care about if Gaijin didn't fuck it up with the reward system, because now you earn shit on the defeat, just like World of Tanks. Thank you so much for fucking that up, Gaijin. If it didn't fuck up like that, well, then I wouldn't really have too much of a problem with the defeat. I mean, I still try and win, but it's not as devastating when I go and have this awesome match and get a defeat on it, just so happened to, because that's all that I get on those are defeats. I could go and I can get a 5 to 8 kill match in simulator battles there, and nope, it'll still be a defeat. But either way, chances are this one will be a defeat then. We are capping B and they are capping A. Interesting. A lot of people to choose from here. Boy, it's so much prettier looking. Eighteen, 19. Which means stop fucking moving. Look for movement. Stop fucking moving and look for movement. I've seen Germans come over here. And I catch them off guard. That is a mosquito. That has just shot down a BF-110. Yeah, my points are still going up, but these guys could be anywhere.
Enemy forces have captured that zone.
I'm reluctant to believe that there is somebody in A. I'm taking my attention away to the east, or to the left of me here. For a second I thought that guy was coming down on me. Okay, so there's somebody capping the A zone. Which, once they decide to come out, hopefully they will die. The A zone is just through those trees, so I can't frickin'. I hope that was my own engine that I just heard.
Enemy forces have captured a zone.
Okay, they've got A.
Need cover.
I see enemy tanks way in the distance, but I'm not gonna take any shots at those guys just yet. Plus they're moving. I'm hoping that whoever capped A is going to come out across this place right here. That's my dream, at least. In a perfect world, I see green machine gun, which is German. Yeah, there's something down there. I just heard the 75. Just pulling out a little bit here. Man, I can see so many things out there, but I don't want to give my position away. That tree just fell over, but it's from gunfire. God damn. I don't want to go to them. I want them to come out for me. Well, I guess I could get a little closer, but the only thing is that's a big risk to take. The bugger. And a complete miss. No worries. Oh shit. Okay. Aimed slightly ahead. We want to take out his driver. He's a driver's down. The last crew member in his tank is somebody on the other side. I can't get the guy on the... Oh, fuck me. Oh shit, okay.
It serves him right.
Yep, that guy's got gunner control let back. Nope, I've just taken a direct hit from something else. Not exactly sure what that was. If it was that guy, I'm calling complete bullshit. It might have been. So, pointless that both of these guys lost their gunner and their loader. And the fact that this guy managed to bounce a shell. There we go. Just jam his turret, but nope, he burned up. Next guy is right here. Who I have lost all sight of now. Yeah, I guess that Panzer IV G there must have shot me first. Which, oh my god, I can't stand that so much. Doesn't matter how much damage you do to them, it seems that they still have the ability to shoot you. And I can't see because my view thing is on the wrong side. He just shot at something to my right. Oh. Either I killed him with my machine gun or he jumped out. And there is now something down over here. Ah, that is an AC-4 Thunderbolt. Okay, we don't want to shoot that. I lost sight on that Panzer IV down there, unless he was killed. Okay, so I was expecting to have a complete failure there, but thankfully the AC-4 kept me alive. Either that or the 17-pounder kept me alive. I bounced quite a few shots there, so I'd have to say the AC-4 is what really caught me or kept me alive, but I lost two of my valuable crew members. And we're grabbing A back. Now I'm going to retreat back to B because I'm not going to forward the assault on A. I am going to fall back in defense of B because I saw a lot of enemy tanks. While we're knocking out quite a few vehicles, I saw a lot of enemy tanks pushing on the right side, but it looks like we were actually holding this. You know, just in case, I'm going to pull over to B and push up that side. Because some people, you know, will say that I'm not doing the right thing by not pushing forward. But I highly disagree. Honestly, I feel that it is just as important to defend a cap zone as it is to push a cap zone. And now we have stopped capturing the zone. Shit, which is... We've got an enemy KV-1B that has moved up. No idea where he is, but... around the A point. And it is. It really is. Because it's just as important to cap a zone as it is to defend a zone, and vice versa. Capping a zone is important because it leads you to victory. But if you don't defend your zone, they could push faster than you. So defending a zone keeps the enemy from pushing faster. That's another AC-4 Thunderbolt. I'm assuming the one that just got killed. KV-1B somewhere up here near A. I'm assuming that's what's capping the zone. I have no sight on anything. Oh, we just lost our M18 to an Ostwind. Typical fucking scumbag. I hit him, but it went straight through without doing much. He seems to be ignoring it, which is good for me. I'm going to aim a little lower and see if I can hit his driver. No, complete miss. Aim too low that time. He's still there. I can see him just through the bushes. He is missing. I can't see him now. I have lost line of fire. And that is a thing right there. Who I think is critically damaged big time. Yeah, he's on fire. Well, I'm going to grab an assist out of that one. Unless I can get one more shot in. Yeah, killed his driver. The last guy's in the turret. There we go, Thunderbolt knocked him out. I thought the last guy would have been the driver. But there must have been two. Oh well. So it was not a KV-1B that was capping the zone? Is that what you tried to tell me? Surprised that there is still so much left here. So much, there are so many enemy vehicles, unless they're... Oh shit, fuck me. That KV-1B is in fact still there, and that... I just knocked out his cannon breach. Great. Look who's joined the party. Well, I got his engine, now he's on fire. That guy will finish out the KV-1, and I'll finish off this fuck. Oh, piss off, mate. Ballsack. Fuck off, mate. Thank fuck you don't have a bomb. I don't think that guy has killed that KV-1. He has not. And now he's being shot at by machine guns. Not sure if that means he has his main cannon back or not, but... I don't want to drop artillery. I just did that recently in a realistic battle match and got my teammate killed. Don't want that to happen again, do we? I think this guy is in last stand mode. AC-4 looks to be coming up from above for a top-down strike. I'll come over from this side of the river. If he doesn't kill him by then, that is. That AC-4 is falling back, as if the KV-1 is looking. We can take this guy out together, mate, but... we have to approach him from different angles. Oh, we just shot each other, and my shell did not penetrate, neither did his. Fallback time! Oh, fuck me, that was close. Okay. Yep, no idea where the hell that came from. So, straight into this. Alright. I'm assuming, I don't know, this guy's charging, he's fired. Ah, his cannon barrel's out. That's fantastic. Okay, now that it's danger close, I am calling down artillery. Can I help this guy repair? That would be a negative. I'd assume he's repairing right now. And I don't know how far away that 75mm shot was. Oh, it's just us. It's just us. Holy shit. Okay. So, where are you going, mate? You're gonna go down. You're gonna go up again? Okay. I will sit here. I have grass turned on, so if he has grass turned off, that would mean he will be able to see and shoot me first. This guy seems to be going up and around, which I'm guessing is a good thing. No, he is still looking this way. He is still fucking looking this way. Okay. Well, if he's looking this way, then that Thunderbolt, I hope that Thunderbolt ain't just running away. I hope he's coming around. Please. Otherwise, I'm going to be left here all alone against a KV-1B. And a dead loader. I want a better sight line on this guy. Yeah, they're capping B. Yeah, that AC-4 Thunderbolt has come under fire. Okay, he has fired. KV-1 has fired. I have fired and apparently bounced off of his... Okay. Sure. There you go. I took out his cannon breech, but still didn't kill his fucking crew member. There we go. Now he's dead. Cap the zone, you say? That is not true. The enemy sky, or the skies are filled with enemy vehicles. Apparently that AC-4 has been killed. I can't get back. Even if I tried capping right now, it wouldn't work. Wouldn't have enough time, and there's J-87s flying around. The only thing I can do is try to get back. With no knowledge of any location of any enemy vehicle. Yeah, that AC-4 Thunderbolt was going around for the KV-1, but as you could see, he was killed by something. Probably to the side or behind him. Just going to get a quick view here to make sure. Man, I can't make it back. This is a complete failure. Damn it. Well, 4 kills on the first match isn't bad. What the hell was that? Come on, that ticket counter was bullshit. I could have gotten at least one more shot into that. Unless they've changed that already, but you know what? That's not what's happened. Whatever. Yeah, right there. That 6,000 would have been way over 10,000 RP on a victory. I don't know why Gaijin thought that was a good idea. It was one reason why it's one of the things I hate the most about Wargaming's games. Because even it's not based off of personal performance. And War Thunder was always unique because it was based off of personal performance. You know? And so if you did perfect, you got rewarded greatly for that. And if you did shit, well, you didn't get rewarded very well. That's why I loved War Thunder so much. And all of a sudden, they decided, hey, you know what? Let's fuck it up for everybody by making it team-based. Which, I love that. But guys, you cannot rely on a random internet team to work together. It is never something to rely on. So you're literally screwing us, me, and other players, goddammit. Whatever. 4 kills, managed not to die. You know what? I'll put that one up. Might as well. It was quite exciting there. And I will continue playing. Let's see if I've got... Let's see what I've got for... boosters. This one ends in 11 hours. Ooh, 10 matches for that one. I'm gonna get rid of this one first, though. Shit, watch me have a really good match. whatever.